boy a turn on the swing. Thank you. Kendra, have you heard the news?
Shh, one sec. Sean, put the baseball bat down. Hit your brother one more time.
The school has lights.
Oh, the county's so irresponsible.
Well, has Sean gotten them? Your hair's beautiful. Do you want me to check you?
Nah, sure, I'm fine.
It's okay. Kendra, you have lice everywhere.
Oh, I'm so tiny.
Oh no, I do have lice. It's the county's fault. The head of the school board's an idiot. They fired him and now they're looking for a new idiot.
Tracy?
Yeah?
How do you get rid of them?
Myrtle Beach, here we come. Everybody in, we're in.
Buckled up.
Buckled up.
Ignition and liftoff.
Myrtle Beach, Myrtle Beach.
Let me check in with
WTOP.
All the eggs and when it breaks. Rockview Parkway backed up from the Kennedy Center to Massachusetts Avenue.
Oh, that's where I was gonna go. I'll take Memorial Bridge the other way then.
Memorial Bridge closed until September.
Hey, check on Roosevelt Bridge.
Ah, you have to go through Georgetown.
Street Bridge.
Protesters blocking all lanes.
Oh, New York out!
Construction.
295.
Parking lot.
VW Parkway!
Rolled over truck blocking all lanes.
We are going to the beach if it's the last thing I do. We're elected the Delaware beaches.
Bay Bridge blocked all the way to Wisconsin Avenue.
No sodas till we get to the beach.
Just want you to be safe
by putting me in some place. I'm feeling sick,
you better go now.
You can't keep putting this off, Rose.
I'm not going to a nursing home. Mary Jones just moved in with her daughter.
Ma, I think you should get some rest now. Clark and I need to go and talk this over.
There's nothing to talk about. Lauren, we are getting this woman a new pair of shoes.
This month. July is all about new development.
That's amazing. I was literally just talking about how much I missed reading.
No, yeah, like, would you want to read together or something?
Maybe. I'm just waiting for this guy to come over.
Wait, okay.
Just this guy said he was going to text me and then he didn't, so I'm like, what?
No, yeah, that's like weird. Well, just text me if he doesn't text you and then we can go to the gym or whatever. I mean, it's whatever.
Yeah, for sure. I'll just let you know when I know more about what's happening.
Fine. Great. That's amazing. I love you so much.
Boston, April 8, 1775. Dearest husband, the bonds of my affection grow stronger the longer we are apart.
I went to the movies this afternoon, my darling, and longed for you. I grew so lonesome that I held my own hand and pretended it was yours.
I've grown quite thin. Do not fret.
I hope you like the photo. Arlene says I look like Rita Hayworth.
By the grace of God, we will be reunited again soon.
I'll be looking at the moon. But I'll be seeing you.
How to talk to women. Things to say that make you sound classy and likable. Pickup lines. Pickup lines that aren't cheesy. Top ten. Are you from Tennessee?
Sorry?
Are you from Tennessee?
No, I'm not.
No, sorry. Are you from Tennessee? Because you're the only 10 I see.
Oh, I get it.
Creepers on the bus. I want to get a creeper on the bus to not talk to you.
What you're doing here is illegal. You can't keep me here like this. Do you know who I am?
Your name is Grant Kilbane.
You're 31 years old.
You live with your boyfriend, Stephen, in a one-bedroom apartment in Cleveland Park.
You have one living grandparent, three sisters, a dog, and your parents have been divorced for 2 years.
You hate summer, love fall. Your favorite color is brown.
You're 5'9" and 160 pounds.
You're allergic to kiwi and soy.
You've been working at COSI for 2 years since losing your job at the National Zoo.
See? The government is stealing my information.
Son, that was all from Facebook.
Oh my god, I think we should call someone.
Wait! Fuck, no more storage? Seriously?
I think he needs help. I mean, his leg.
Let me get the filter off.
I know how to use a fucking iPhone, Ed! Shut recording!
I'm gonna call someone.
Shut up, I'm filming.
Sorry, Ed. Make sure I'm not in the shot.
You're not! Holy shit!
Oh, he's bleeding. Look at all
that. Yep, there it is. That's it. This is gonna go viral.
Good morning, crew. Alright. Oh, what is it? Is it the Pride Parade?
We're making a video. This black guy was holding a parking spot for his wife, and this cop let him out of a chokehold.
Oh. Oh, God. Does this skirt make me look huge?
Dick says, "That's a sweet ass."
Huh.
Because from behind it looks like...
No, I get the position. Does the dick have legs too?
He's just some guy being a dick.
Well, Lawrence with a Y, if you want to be reductive about the sexes, maybe make the guy being a dick just a dick. That way, at least you're equally reductive. I can't believe I just said that.
Is that funnier?
Yes, Morris. It's funnier.
Hey.
Hey, baby.
Damn!
Hey, I've got a smile.
You know what I'm saying? So he couldn't possibly be guilty.
really messed her up. She's got panic attacks and depression, and she's a completely different person. I thought about killing her. Bought a gun and everything. Crazy, right?
No, not crazy at all. Motherfucker.
Motherfucker.
Look, I am set up by society to not trust my own thinking, even when I know more than you do. Your turn.
And I'm set up to not trust your thinking, even though you know more than I do.
And?
And? Okay, okay, I'm set up to act like I know what I'm talking about, even though I don't.
And it's the wall.
The wall.
The glass wall.
Wait, I thought it was a ceiling.
It's a wall.
I keep trying to touch you, but I can't.
You can't. I know you're trying. I'm trying too.
I'm sorry it wasn't enough, but I still love you.
I love you too. Don't stop trying.
What's your life?
I'm an IRS agent, but I identify as a postal worker.
Interesting.
Everyone loves getting mail. No one likes an audit.
Contestant number two.
I'm a marketing director, but I identify as a serial killer.
Oh, so you have a target audience. Contestant number three.
I'm a police officer. Some days I identify as the Dalai Lama. Others, the Incredible Hulk.
Oh, so you plan for two, is that it?
I'm a deeply divided self. It's hell not knowing who you are.
Are you all right? You're looking a little green.
Are you making fun of me?
Not at all.
Because I can't stand it when people make fun of me!
And I'm your host, but I identify as out of here.
Oh, yes.
Right there.
Oh, Tony never did that.
Robin was never.
Oh, God!
Am I going too fast?
Too much?
No.
Not enough.
Oh, this is too perfect.
That is perfect.
Oh, too good.
So damn good. Damn!
How am I gonna fuck it up this time?
I love you.
Hey, hon. Bad time?
It's fine.
What's wrong? You sound weird.
I need to talk to you about something.
Oh, God. What? You're getting gender reassignment surgery?
Myra.
You're secretly black.
Not funny. I'm getting divorced.
Again? Mom, this is
number three, I know. I don't know what to tell you, sweetheart.
I never liked him. He could be a real asshole.
All right.
Jake never liked him either.
I'm no good at picking husbands, I guess.
Except for Dad.
Except for Dad.
Which you screwed up.
I completely screwed up.
So what now?
I wish I knew.
And God hates sex outside of marriage.
Your father and I didn't even kiss until we were married.
I have sinned. I touched a girl, you know, down there.
What was she wearing?
A nightgown.
She flaunted herself in a nightgown?
She was asleep at first.
How is it that you're around girls when they're asleep?
Your sister?
Well, boys are curious.
Yes. This is wrong. Do you promise to stop?
I think. I'm not sure.
We're there for you. We'll get counseling for
you. We're going to see you through this ordeal.
attracted to both sexes and two genders, but not necessarily simultaneously. I'm Mary, and I'm cisgender. My gender identity corresponds with the gender slash sex I was assigned at birth.
I'm Chris, and I'm a trans man, non-op. I was born a female, but I identify as male. I had sexual reassignment through hormones, but not surgery.
We are your sexual orientation leaders! Ready? Here we go!
Call out when you hear the letter you identify with. L.
Lesbian, attracted to another woman.
G.
Genderqueer, non-conforming to either gender.
Q.
Queer and loving it.
Q. I. Yes! Person in the back?
Not sure, still questioning.
And I'm a straight, white, privileged male that has been granted special immunity in this country.
Next?
Sir, I think you're next, sir.
Excuse me? Sir? Why do you assume I'm a man?
Excuse me, people are waiting.
I will have you know I am a transgender lesbian who identifies as a gay gender, non-conforming two-spirit, and I will not be othered by the likes of you, spewing out your vile hate. So now tell me, what am I? Tell me.
I just wanted a latte.
Oh yeah, well I wanted a latte too, but this culture's let me down all my life.
Okay, next customer. What can I get for you, sister?
Now why would you call me sister? Like you don't know my life.
Here we go.
White people are crazy. I just wanted
a latte! I'm a woman.
You don't look like a woman.
Trust me.
Okay. I'm black.
You don't look black.
Trust me.
You don't look black.
Trust me, I feel black.
I feel like a woman.
You don't feel like a woman.
You don't feel...
No!
Hey, baby.
Excuse me?
Hey.
Nope.
Oh, shit. Sorry, officer. We on our way home. Just saying hey.
No, 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 Crystal. Hold up. We support the police.
I said something make you think I'm interested?
You ain't on duty.
Go home, gentlemen.
Ladies.
Excuse me? You know, I'm trying to do you a favor. A guy like you got himself killed 2 blocks up last week.
Then why you ain't got us under arrest then, officer?
Girl, you take your crazy pills tonight.
Looking in one of two ways.
All right. We go.
Jesus. Come on!
See you here tomorrow then?
Okay, contestants! Name one thing that is still prevalent today.
Racism.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
But it is.
I'm sorry, it's 2015 and that answer is unacceptable. Yeah. Okay, contestants, name an age old sexual orientation.
Transgender.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
But it's age old.
However, people think it's new, so the answer is incorrect.
Me, a gay?
Ooh, can you be more specific?
No, it's nuance.
I'm sorry, I need an answer.
Homosexuality.
Incorrect. Well, close. The top answer is transgender.
But that's what I said.
Public opinion swayed. Next question. Name the one thing young people care about.
Their friends.
Incorrect.
It's their fault.
Ooh, now the top answer.
The environment.
Yes, the environment. However, we can't give you any points because nobody is doing anything about it. Okay, for the win. Name the race that can never be won.
Oh, the
doors closing. Boop, boop.
Would you look at that jerk?
Paging Mr. Manspread.
Your balls are not that huge, bro.
I bet his ego is.
Jesus Christ, do you believe this?
God, it's like his legs are magnetically repulsive.
He's definitely repulsive.
You know what we should do? We should sit on either side.
Damn.
Oh. That is just not normal.
You just want to jam your high-heeled foot in his...
Right in his... Yeah.
When's it gonna stop? can't slow down. There's a claw on my tail.
Here it comes. I got it.
No, I didn't.
You never do. I told you to hit the shutter a second early.
I did that.
You know, we've passed that sign 1,000 times. I don't know why you need a stupid picture of it.
Because it is an incredible sign. No exit to Democratic Boulevard. So ironic.
It's ironic about it. There's no space between this ramp and that exit. You'd have an accident if you tried.
That's the irony. Democracy denied. And D.C., the center of American democracy.
We're not in D.C. yet, we're in Maryland.
Denied! You are so literal.
Thank you, I try.
Sartre would appreciate that song.
Who?
Jean-Paul Sartre? Remember his play, No Exit?
Not sure. Was it a movie?
A divorce?
They say I am a streetcar. Why am I here? Ding ding! Sorry, you can't get on yet.
I thought you would be running. We just paid a large amount for a condo next to the streetcar.
Am I for fun? Ding ding! Sorry, you can't get on yet.
Business.
Am I for trouble? Ding ding! Sorry, you can't get on yet.
What are you talking about? I don't want to get on. I'm a city bus. Check me out, fancy pants.
Am I for nothing? Confused as ever. Well, I guess I'll have to do another circuit.
Keeping you
you apart from your twin flame.
But the gold Rolex I gave you!
To go back in time and cleanse the spirits of your past
life. Okay, the $80,000!
To build a gold bridge to trap the evil spirits in the other realm.
I have sold my car. I borrowed from my family. I can give you more, but all I have on me right now is $1.
Just enough for a daily insight. Cut. The night of cups reversed. The monkey's paw. We get exactly what we want.
Impecunity?
No, Max. Solitude. Keep coming back! Oh, look at those jackasses out there! You're not getting anything from me!
gone by, this city had no street beggars.
Oh, pre-biblical?
It was a time of national harmony, shining hills, shining cities.
Oh, pre-Reagan.
Whatever happened?
Reagan!
There are jobs out there waiting to be filled if only one looks.
Oh, come on, man. All I'm asking for is a buck.
How about 20?
What's the catch?
Convince me you deserve it.
Okay, I'll give you my mom's number.
Show me you're worthy.
Aw. No, no tax.
Oh, no. Make me want to help you. Make me need it.
Come on, man.
Prove to me that we have one thing in common and the money is yours.
Fuck you!
We'll be right back. were going. The actors needed the jobs. They hated the play, too. Sometimes speaking up is a risk we can't always afford to take.
I'm hungry now.
I need a drink now.
So what'd you think?
Sometimes you have to speak anyway.
I hate it.
And that's it, the Smithsonian National Museum of African American History and Culture.
Wow!
Opening in 2015, finally.
Wow.
Isn't it? Such a prominent place on the mall, right in the heart of everything.
It is.
It's such a great location, and don't you love the building?
Well, it's the last available space in the mall.
Yeah, but it's still an amazing location, and it's gonna have everything. Exhibitions, programming, classes, all dedicated to exploring the richness of the African American experience in this country. A whole building full of it.
Full of it. All of it?
What's wrong?
All.
What can I do? Please tell me what I can do.
I don't know. I just don't know.
Trayvon Martin. Martin?
No.
Michael Brown?
No.
Eric Garner?
No.
Azelle Ford?
No.
Tamia Rice?
No.
Walter Scott?
No.
Tanisha Anderson?
No.
Sandra Bland?
No.
Freddie Gray?
No.
Who then?
Jon Snow in Game of Thrones!
Okay, what would you like to discuss? Well, not again.
I have filed an official complaint with the dean of the college.
You filed like 16 complaints this semester alone. This one for old man in the sea.
Animal cruelty is my trigger.
And then this one, the color purple.
Racism, also my trigger.
What about Slaughterhouse-Five? What is wrong with Slaughterhouse-Five?
Animal cruelty again.
There is no animal cruelty in Slaughterhouse-Five.
It's implied in the title. I was too triggered to read it.
East of Eden. Invisible Man. Absalom, Absalom. The Joy Luck Club.
Those have all triggers. Impossible to learn, those are all triggers.
Bitch, real life is your trigger.
I don't see race. I don't see what the problem is.
I don't see why you're so upset.
I don't see it.
I don't see race. I don't see how you can say that.
I don't see the point.
I don't see why this is such a big deal.
I don't see race.
I don't see how this is my problem.
I don't see what this has to do with me.
I don't see why you would think that.
I don't see race.
I don't see race.
I don't see race.
I don't see...
I don't see...
I don't. I don't. I don't.
I...
Stop running! Put your hands in the air!
I've been doing
it! Did I tell you to say anything? Did I ask you to explain anything?
I'm
shut
not
up!
Talking,
I don't care what you gotta say, you little punk!
Okay. Okay.
Are you deaf? No. I know you heard me. Now act like you got some sense and put your hands in the air. Are you trying to get smart with me? Boy, pull up your pants.
I can't pull my pants up unless I put my hands down. You might shoot me.
I'm not going to shoot you. Now pull your damn pants up. Boy, whose clothes are you wearing?
I don't know. Me and my mom was at the laundromat and she told me to go to the store and get some Oreos. But all my clothes was in the dryer, so she handed these pants out of somebody else's basket and said, hurry up. So that's what I did. And now I'm not going to be able to get her Oreos. And man, she going to be mad.
Okay, stop. Crying. You get back to the laundromat and get those clothes back in the basket before the owner shows up. I will head over to 7-Eleven, get your mom some Oreos and meet you there.
Why you do that for me?
A little justice in action, kid.
Someone posted another police video to my news feed. Getting tired of it.
Tired's not the word. These police shootings are exhausting and scary.
No, the murders are fucking awful, but I was talking about my actual newsfeed. Every day it seems I get another YouTube or Vine or Dashcam, and I know that cops are a problem, but can a brother get a Jimmy Fallon clip on his feed? Something from Conan, a BuzzFeed listicle? And if it's not police videos clogging my feed, it's posts on marriage equality, gender pay gap, and public breastfeeding. Actually, I don't mind the breastfeeding. Lactating milk's kind of turning me on. Yeah. But what really gets to me are the posts on privilege. I understand the concept of privilege. I get the historical argument. But how much more privileged am I than you? Like, personally, we were both raised middle class, both went to top schools, both work at the same firm. Hey, how long does it take to hail a freaking cab in the city? You're doing it wrong.
We're still doing the same exact thing you're doing now, but
here's one.
Thank you.
What are you doing loitering here?
Loit? This is a park bench.
Paying an awful lot of attention to that electronics store.
I'm waiting for it to open. I want to get a gift for my father.
So you're planning to pay?
You calling me a thief?
I think your daddy's going to be pleased when he has to come downtown and bail you out.
What for?
Don't get so excited. Why don't you just leave and we can forget this little incident?
There isn't any incident.
Fast!
Oh, and just what are you running from?
That cop back there, she told me.
Running from a police officer? Oh, you must have done something real bad. Love CVS.
All the coupons.
They're rebuilding. They didn't cut and run.
Cut and run because of?
What happened?
What happened?
The thugs.
Thugs?
Didn't you see the fire? They slashed the hoses with knives.
Burn, baby, burn. Why slash the hose? Why burn, baby, burn? Do you know why? Because I know why.
Well, I bought stock in CVS because they're staying to rebuild. You should buy stock in CVS too.
I just bought a sewing kit.
Dude, check it out!
What you got?
This one's perfect! Check out the shape! It even looks like a trigger.
We spent hours looking for those!
Remember when we played bank robbers? We'd hide these under our shirts and scare the crap out of my sister.
Man, she freaked.
Can't do that anymore, huh?
Yeah. Kid got in trouble for a damn Pop-Tart.
Stick him up!
Don't, man. That scares the hell out of me now.
It's a stick. Get it? Stick him up.
He's so stupid.
He's got a gun! Grab him!
It's a stick!
Are you okay?
I got him!
Let me go!
He didn't hurt you!
I said let me go, damn it!
Were you threatened? I felt hurt.
Leave him alone!
You're all right now. You're all right.
January 9th, 2007. Troy Chesley, African-American, age 30. Detective Chesley was shot and killed in Baltimore City. Chesley had just completed his shift when he was approached by two suspects who shot him several times. Hashtag violent end to his work day.
June 11, 2010, Wesley Brown, African-American, age 24. Maryland State Trooper Brown was shot and killed while escorting a customer out of a restaurant who refused to pay a bill. As Trooper Brown stood in the parking lot, the suspect pulled the gun and shot him. Hashtag officer killed by deadbeat diner.
January 9, 2011, William Torbett, African-American, age 33. Baltimore City police officer William Torbett was shot and killed while attempting to stop a fight at a local nightclub. Although Torbett identified himself as law enforcement, fellow police officers mistook him as the offender and shot him numerous times. Hashtag inadvertent fire.
Is it dead?
He's not an it.
It doesn't deserve to be called a human. No human being can do what that thing did. Shooting people who are in the middle of praying for the salvation of people they don't even know.
The Bible says forgive sinners.
Bible says eye for an eye. Let's kill him. Come on. Hurry up.
I'm not touching that gun. If that's what you're thinking, you can forget it.
You know what will happen if we don't take care of it now. Tomorrow it will sell a story to some magazine and maybe get some made-for-TV movie starring some rich Hollywood star talking about how terrible his childhood was and how hard it was being poor and stupid until the pressure got to be so much that it temporarily lost his mind and went out and shot 9 people it never met before.
Ambulance will be here soon. Police too. Sounds like things are about to be taken out of our control.
When have things ever been in our control? Damn. Hand me that pillow.
What are you going to do?
Hush! Hand me the pillow. When I was born, I was called.
Baby boy. Son.
My son.
Brother.
Cubs.
A gift.
A gift.
A gift.
When I was 5, I was called.
Lil B.
Playful.
Creative.
Smart.
Rowdy.
Wild.
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 When I was 9, I was called.
Behind.
Cut up.
Class clown.
Poorly behaved.
Common.
A problem.
Problem.
A problem.
When I was 13.
When I was 13?
Only 13.
Oh, for real? You were 13? Because I was only 12.
When I was 12.
And when I was 13.
And 14.
And 15.
And 16.
And 17.
And still not 18.
Never to reach 18.
I was called.
Thug.
But what group?
They're marginalized. Wait,
There are a lot there.
Okay, say you're looking at the Earth from a distance. Who is the most marginalized?
There are a lot of them. All the children in Africa. Ooh, there are a lot of them. What if we could walk through time?
The Jews had it pretty bad.
Looks bad. They did.
And the black people, they had it really bad.
Still do.
But whoa, the white people?
The white people had it pretty good.
Yeah.
For a really, really long time. Whoa. Looks like a lot of people are going to have to forgive them.
Well, I didn't do all that.
When everyone comes together and sees the world as one.
I didn't do all that.
People are going to have to forgive the lineage. That's what I mean.
Oh, that's a double whammy.
Tell me about the riots in your town.
You've heard that before.
Tell me again.
Oh, I was 15 years old and I was working in my daddy's store. They turned the hoses on the picketers and the water sounded so loud that it was going to force down the windows. I hid under a desk in Daddy Jules' office.
Then what?
What do you mean?
Did you make them turn the hoses off? Did you help the protesters?
They would have arrested us. They would have destroyed Daddy Jules' store. Besides, we already had to be careful. We were the only Jews in there.
Who would have arrested you?
The white people in our town? Why are you asking me this?
I'm just wondering what I should do, what I can do.
That was 50 years ago in rural North Carolina.
No, Grandma, that was yesterday in this town.
Don't hide under a desk.
Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Let me see you do that yoga. Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Baby, bend over. Make your booty do that yoga. Baby, bend over. Hey.
A white gunman opened fire in a historic black church in Charleston, South Carolina, killing 9 people.
A white gunman opened fire at a historic black church in Charleston, South Carolina, killing 9
white police officers.
A white gunman opened fire at a historic black church in Charleston, South Carolina, killing 9 people. Another black teenager was shot and killed on August 9th by a white police officer in Ferguson, Missouri. A white gunman opened fire at a historic black church in Charleston, South Carolina, killing 9 people.
Fuck!
Should we make an offer?
Hell no! This town can't handle the honest truth.
You're toast.
Oh shit! The body of security! That proof!
Your lord, not that proof. Hillary! Your time has come!
Apartment. You can't be too picky, especially this near Logan Square.
No kidding. Or anywhere else in this messed up city. I've been looking for 2 weeks.
Well then.
All right, I'll take it.
Oh, terrific. Let me just check the current price. Oh, $3,000.
What? The ad said 2,000.
Oh, I'm sorry. The market moves really fast. Hold on. Oh, 3,500. Better jump in there.
This is nuts.
Make that 4,000.
Forget it.
Not so fast. What kind of budget are we talking about?
Well...
You can whisper if you're embarrassed.
Ouch.
I see. Well, no need to fret.
Really?
You might have a chance. Oh, we have a few open steam grates near the NSA building.
What?
Plenty of heat in the winter, although I should warn you, there is a waiting list.
This country is imploding, collapsing on itself under the weight of
negativity,
willful ignorance, inconsistent application of values, and a refusal by nearly everyone.
Negativity is eating us alive.
To make the most simple changes required to save themselves, their communities.
We're poisoning each other. We're poisoning ourselves.
Or their planet. I'm posting this petition.
I'm posting this classic poem.
Sign or you don't
click
care.
Like to prove you have a soul.
Focus on change.
Focus on the good.
Be outraged.
Be one with the universe.
Are you okay?
I don't know. I just suddenly got all... Who are you?
My mother's daughter.
Is that the best answer?
No.
But the best answer takes years to tell, with both of us paying real individualized attention to both my answer and yours.
And then we have to do that with everyone else, too. Listen to them as individuals?
Yes.
Cool. I'm gonna need some coffee first.
Chris Weber.
Rod Strickland.
Rasheed Howard.
Welcome, Bert.
Ah!
God? Is this heaven?
Not really.
Jawan Howard?
Gilbert Arenas.
Why are they naming former famous Washington Wizards players?
Gives us hope.
They made it out of purgatory. Maybe one day we will too.
Rick Hamilton. Michael Jordan.
Hey, hello. Are you Sam? I'm sorry I'm late.
It is so
traffic.
Great to finally meet you, Captain America. So glad Kathy was able to put you on the schedule. Have a seat.
Thank you.
So, I'm gonna cut straight to the chase here, Steve. I assume you've already been briefed on the deal, am I right?
Alright.
We are the third most valuable NFL franchise, right behind those damn Patriots and those bastards in Dallas.
Language! Do you mean the Cowboys?
That's right. We are worth $1.6 billion, and all this trademark nonsense is threatening all of that. Our brand worth alone is $131 million!
That is a lot of money, Cap.
That's what I hear.
And that is where you come in. This endorsement deal is going to solve everyone's problems. All you have to do is smile with the guys and wear a t-shirt.
Oh, good. That's not what we
do. No. All you have to do is smile and wear a Redskins t-shirt.
Language!
Bum, 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 bum.
RHT News.
If you're just tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, the election has just been called. We have a new president-elect.
It is an historic day.
Is it an historic day? Or a historic day?
Some might say both, Emily.
Cut to the feed from Washington. We can see the Hilton where the concession speech is about to take place. As their candidate makes his way to the stage, he is applauded by his loving supporters. Before the speech, would anyone like to speculate about potential candidates for 2020? We have more than just speculation. With 1,460 days remaining until the next election, three hopefuls have already announced their candidates. Let's go to that story.
You'll see.
no more. Hardly bark these days.
Angelo decrepit. You and me too.
Problem is, ain't no sun for him out here in the yard. Not no more.
Angelo always liked his share of bright.
Makes him dozy.
Sunlight make me dozy too.
Is that add-on structure or whatever? Shadowed away the sun from us.
What do they call that thing?
Ronnie says it's a pop-up. Peel the roof off a row house and build heavenward.
Pop gone up, sun shut out.
I'm gonna give Ronnie Hager's sun lamp in the doghouse.
Give Angelo a tan.
Woo! Angelo, come on! Angie, baby!
He ain't paying you no heed.
Ain't nothing like it used to be.
Nah, ain't nothing ever again be like it was.
I'm not really sleeping well.
Falling asleep or staying asleep?
Both. I didn't even know them. But I can't stop. I can't stop thinking about their faces as it was happening. I'm in that room with them. I picture the wallpaper, what they were wearing, what he was wearing. I know it's crazy.
Is that why you
I guess can't? I need to know what happened.
You wouldn't want to.
I need to see it. I don't want to. I have to.
It's not yours to have.
I want to be a part of it. Standing on the outside of something is so... Even when it's scary, it's always easier being on the inside, isn't it?
It's never easy. It's just important.
But you're a teacher.
Teacher or preacher doesn't make you
sick. But you're wrong about people.
Experience teaches us otherwise.
At the end of the day, you have to trust them.
Right.
Different worldviews, I guess.
Realistic and un.
Goodness spreads. Goodness is contagious. It opens up. It touches people, changes them. Here, nothing can change that.
This can. No one's gonna hurt my kids.
It's higher than I thought it'd be.
Right? Right.
I could roll right down that hill.
You should. In honor of the 16th president. Honest Abe won it that way.
What way?
Honest!
And?
Terrified.
I'm not terrified.
I'm talking about me.
Oh.
I'm terrified that everything will be the same after this moment. Aren't you?
No.
Why?
Because I love you.
I'm still terrified.
You're allowed.
Was there anything before just now?
Yes.
How do you know?
I remember.
But what if there was nothing before this moment? What if all our memories are simply implants and the whole universe just started right now?
But it didn't. I remember.
But how do you know for certain your memories are real? Or what if we're caught in some kind of loop where there was only this moment happening over and over? You hit me!
Did I?
Yes, I remember it.
But what if all our memories are simply implants, and the whole universe just started right now?
Was there anything before just now?
Yes.